Hi, my name is Krishna Martinson. I am an associate professor in the Department of Animal Science at the University of Minnesota. And this is Amanda Grev, and she's a master's student also at the University of Minnesota. So today we're going to talk about how to physically evaluate hay. And we're going to talk about a few of the major components that we look for when we evaluate hay. The first one is maturity. And maturity is so important because that is what drives forage quality. So you can see we have some different hays laid out on the table here. Here we have a grass hay, and you can see it is mature because you can physically see the seed heads. So a hay that has this much seed heads is a more mature hay. It doesn't mean it's a bad hay. It just means it is more mature and should probably be fed to horses that have a lower caloric requirement. Compared, here's a grass hay that is much less mature. You can see when you look in this hay, there are no seed heads. So we know that this hay is relatively immature. This hay would have more energy, more crude protein, less fiber than the more mature hay. When it comes to alfalfa, we do not look for seed heads, we look for flowers. So we want to see both of these alfalfa hays are fairly similar. You can see there is not a lot of flowers. This one's maybe a tad more mature simply because it has bigger stems. So in alfalfa, we look for the flowers. The flower colors are purple or white or pink, and we look for the stem size. Compared to this, which doesn't have really any flowers, much, much smaller stems. So again, a less mature hay. So along with maturity, the other thing that we look at is the species that is in the hay. You can see here we have alfalfa. It has trifoliate leaves. Here is a red clover. It is also a legume. Both red clover and alfalfa are legumes. And here we have a couple blades of orchard grass, and then, of course, our brome grass seed head. So again, you can see we have two legumes, alfalfa and red clover, and then two representative cool season grasses, smooth brome grass and orchard grass. And the reason we want to know what species are in the hay is that if it isn't one of these, it's likely a weed. And we do not want weeds in our horse hay. The other thing is that our legumes tend to be higher in crude protein, higher in calcium, and lower in non-structural carbohydrate content compared to our grasses. So we can use this to our advantage when we are selecting different types of hays to feed to different classes of horses. And along with the higher amounts of crude protein, higher calcium, and lower amounts of non-structural carbohydrates, our legume hays baled at the say a similar maturity to our grass hays will have more energy. They will be more energy dense. And again, that is something you can use to your advantage when feeding different classes of horses. The other components we want to look at are touch, color, and smell. So if we look here, we have two pretty contrasting colors. We have our nice, deep, dark green alfalfa grass mix hay here. Then we have our more faded grass hay. Honestly, color doesn't matter all that much. What a lighter colored hay means is that it was exposed to sunlight or maybe exposed to rain, and some of the vitamins and minerals have leached out. However, even the best quality, deepest, darkest, greenest hay that you can find is going to be lacking in a few essential vitamins and minerals. So it's important to be feeding a ration balancer when you're solely feeding the horse hay and they do not have access to a pasture. And again, that ration balancer fills in the gaps of those vitamins and minerals that are missing in the hays. So don't get too hung up on color. If you're really concerned about color, request a hay forage analysis to really see what you have. If you feel, and Amanda can kind of pull hers apart, because this hay is a little bit more mature, again, you can see the Timothy seed heads in this hay. It is a little bit, it's not quite as soft, but it's not scratchy. It doesn't have prickers, it doesn't have thistles or sand burrs in it. And of course, this hay is pretty soft. Yep. It's nice, you can just see the amounts of leaves in this hay. So again, you want it to be soft and you want it just to feel good when you stick your hand in. Horses have really sensitive mouths and tongues, so if it pricks your hands and it pricks your arms, it's going to cause them some problems as well. So one of the final things we're going to talk about, but it really is critically important, is the presence of mold and dust and weeds. So over here, we really have kind of our top premium quality hay. Here is some hay that has molded. The moisture at which the hay was baled is going to indicate whether it's going to mold or not. So as long as the moisture is below 15%, we won't see mold. If the hay is baled above 18%, we're likely going to see mold. Characteristics of mold, I'm not going to try to breathe deeply because this is quite moldy, but you can smell it. And if you pull apart the flakes, you can see the white mold, you can see the black mold. It does have a very strong smell. And in fact, you can actually see the mold spores rising up. And if you compare the color, it's dark. The darkness means that it's been heated. The molds produce heat as they multiply. And of course, mold is incredibly detrimental to horses. If you ever smell the hay or see this physical signs of mold, that is a sign to reject the hay. There's other classes of livestock that might be able to tolerate a little bit of mold, but horses are incredibly susceptible and moldy hay should be rejected. Also in this hay, we see a few weeds. We see a few different weedy grasses. This happens to be barnyard grass. Not a poisonous plant, but again, we want to keep non-poisonous weeds to less than 10%. And of course, if we have a poisonous weed like Horiolissum, that is of course an automatic rejection. So in conclusion, the take-home messages are to know the maturity. Look for signs of seed heads. Look for bigger stems or smaller stems. Look for flower development in alfalfa. Maturity is the biggest driver of forage quality. Know the species. Know whether you're feeding an alfalfa or a grass hay, or maybe a, say, alfalfa grass hay mix. Don't get too hung up on color, although obviously a dark green hay is better in quality, but don't pass over on those lighter or bleached colored hays. They still can have a lot of great nutrients in them. Of course, we want hays that are soft. We also want hays that are always free of mold, dust, and poisonous plants. So those are the key things to remember when physically evaluating your hay.